Hello and welcome to cookingflavors.com. For today's recipe, we look at the preparation of puri kiranga masala, that is kiranga masala, the potato masala for puri. It also goes well with chapatis. Here are the list of ingredients that are required for this. I've taken a pan and I'm adding about 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil. While the oil is getting hot, let me show you. I've taken about 5 to 6 medium-sized potatoes. I halved them and I've pressure cooked them for about 4 to 5 whistles. And then I've peeled the skin and I've just crumbled it roughly. You can crumble it to how much ever bigger pieces you want. I have it slightly big. Now the oil is hot. I'm adding in about a teaspoon of mustard seeds, and then I'm adding in about a teaspoon of cumin seeds. Once they crackle, I'm adding in a teaspoon of urad dal and chana dal. We'll wait for these dals to get a little brown. Then I'm adding a few pieces of cashew nuts. Cashew nuts gives you an enriched flavor for this dish, but it's totally optional. Once the cashew nuts are brown, I'm adding in some curry leaves and coriander leaves, some ginger and green chilies. We'll saute that all well, and then I'm adding in about one large sized onion, which I have chopped roughly, and we'll saute them till they get nice and translucent. I've added a little bit of salt so that they fry faster. Now I'm adding in about 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and we'll give that a good mix till the turmeric powder leaves out its raw smell. I'm adding in just one small sized tomato, which I roughly chopped. Tomato is optional, but also gives an additional flavor to this dish. We'll saute that well, and we'll mix that all together. And I'm just covering it with a lid just for about 3 minutes till the tomatoes get nice and mashy and it becomes nice and pulpy. That'll just take about 3 minutes. Now I'm adding in about 1 cup of water. Now I'm not giving you an exact measurement for this water because it depends on how much potatoes you have. So you just have to make a mental calculation of how much water you require. For the amount of potatoes I have, I've added about 1 cup of water, and if need be, I'll be adding some more water. If at all after adding the potatoes you feel that the amount of water is less, what you do is add hot water. Don't by any chance add cold water. Just add hot water in case after adding the potatoes you feel the water is less. But before that, just add plain water, room temperature water you can add, and then I'm adding in the required amount of salt. Always when you add salt to the water, it should be a little sharp on your tongue. It's always a best idea to add in a little, and then if you want, you can check and add in a lot more. Now I'm adding in a few coriander leaves, and I'm waiting for the water to come to a nice rolling boil. Now you see the water has come to a nice rolling boil, and now it's time to add in the boiled potatoes. I'm scattering the potatoes here and there so that they don't form a lump or a mass in one place. So here and there I'm adding in the potatoes, and I'm making sure that they get mixed nicely. Now see, this kiranga masala is a little watery in texture. Now as you keep, I'll keep simmering it just for 5 minutes because all the cooking is done. They just have to blend together. After resting and after it cools down, it'll get a little thicker. So you have to switch it off when it's in a little watery consistency. Finally, I'm adding in some more coriander leaves and curry leaves. Now you see, this at this stage I'll switch it off. It looks a little runny, but after it rests it will get a little thick. This is almost, this recipe preparation is almost like preparing an upma recipe. So it's very, very similar. You add all this, add water, allow the water to come to a boil, add the potatoes, simmer and switch off the stove. Our flavorful and delicious puri kiranga masala is ready, which is the perfect combination for puris. Also goes very well with chapatis and rotis. Do try out the recipe and give us your feedback. If you are new to our YouTube channel, welcome and subscribe to our channel. If you like this video, share it with your friends. You can also visit us at cookingflavors.com. Till we see you again with another new and interesting recipe, thank you and happy cooking.